Greetings. Islam tries to claim Mohammed is the prophet of Deuteronomy 18. This has certainly been addressed before in many videos, but I had a very honest question recently and thought it merited a video answer. This is in reference to another video, Is Mohammed Mentioned in the Bible, Part 2? Please click the link if you wish to watch the original video. Just had a question then, who was the prophet that was being referred to then? Here is my answer with expanded scripture references from my original message. Greetings, brother. The Christians know that this is Jesus, based on what Jesus himself said. First, if you compare the prophecy of Deuteronomy 18:15 and 18:18, the prophet would be sent to Israel. Deuteronomy 18:15. The Lord your God will raise up for you a prophet like me from among you, from your brothers. It is to him you shall listen. Moses is speaking to Israel. So the phrase for you means for Israel or to Israel. Deuteronomy 18:18. I will raise up a prophet from among their countrymen like you. And I will put my words in his mouth, and he shall speak to them all that I command him. The phrase, from their countrymen, is variously translated, brethren. King James 2K, from among their brethren. English Standard, from among their brothers. The International Standard, from among their relatives. New American Standard, from among their countrymen. And the NIV, from among their fellow Israelites. Not one translator sees any basis to interpret this as any other than the 12 tribes of Israel. There is no rational or reasonable basis to interpret this as Arabs or Ishmaelites. But this is the desperate, tortured, and erroneous claim Islam tries to make to insert Muhammad as this prophet. Jesus confirms he fulfills this first detail of the prophet of Deuteronomy 18. In Matthew 15:24, but he, Jesus, answered and said, I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. As a prophet, Jesus was specifically sent to Israel and only to Israel. This is in perfect agreement with the terms and details of the prophecy of Deuteronomy 18. The Lord your God will raise up for you a prophet like me. I will raise up a prophet from among their countrymen like you, and I will put my words in his mouth. Please be aware of the following fact. Islam will never, never, never cite Deuteronomy 18:15, because it clearly and explicitly says, for you. Deuteronomy 18:18 does not include this damning phrase. But 18:15 and 18:18 describe the same prophet. Second, and more directly, in Luke 24:44, Jesus said to them, These are the words I spoke to you while I was still with you. Everything must be filled that is written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms. And in John 5:39, you pore over the scriptures because you presume that by them you possess eternal life. These, the scriptures, are the very words that testify about me, Jesus. Luke 24:25. Then Jesus said to them, O foolish ones, how slow are your hearts to believe all that the prophets have spoken? Was it not necessary for the Christ to suffer these things and to enter into his glory? Remember, this was after the crucifixion and the resurrection. Be aware of the following fact. Islam denies both historical events, the crucifixion and the death. But if neither happened, the things Jesus said would be very different. And beginning with Moses, This is Jesus talking, and beginning with Moses and all the other prophets, he explained to them what was written in all the scriptures about himself. Beginning with Moses. If Jesus began with Moses, we know Moses spoke of Jesus. Consider for a moment if Deuteronomy 18 does not speak of Jesus. Where else could Moses have been describing Jesus? This is a real problem for Islam, those who claim Deuteronomy 18 is not about Jesus. If you are Muslim, produce your proof. Where else did Moses speak of Jesus? When you cannot, then begin to honestly face the fact that Islam is making a baseless claim. There is no other mention by Moses of a prophet to come. So Christians know for a fact that Jesus is the prophet of Deuteronomy 18, brother. Please ask if you have any other questions, brother. God loves it when people seek knowledge. This congenial message was followed up with this response. True, but Muslims would say that Jesus wasn't like Moses at all. Did you not say that in your video that the prophet has to be like Moses? Excellent! That is in fact a main Muslim challenge or jihad against the truth. The twisting of the word like, brother. I call this the like jihad. A second Islamic error is to twist the word brother in the phrase from your brothers. As I have pointed out earlier in this video of the discussion, from among their brethren, from among their brothers, from among their relatives, from among their countrymen, from among their fellow Israelites. Not one translator sees any basis to interpret this as Arabs or Ishmaelites. It can only mean the 12 tribes of Israel. In fact, this means Israelite, but Islam tries to change it to mean step-brother, so that it may mean from the descendants of Ishmael. The problem with both jihads against the true meaning is that they ignore the text of Deuteronomy 18:15 and 18:18. The text says, unto you, meaning the prophet is raised up for or to the person Moses is speaking to. The prophet must be sent unto Israel. This does not mean to the world, my friend. It does not mean to Arabia. The phrase to you means to the Jewish people, just like all the other prophets of Yahweh. We'll raise up for you a prophet. We'll raise up unto thee a prophet. We'll raise up a prophet like me for you. We'll raise up to you a prophet. For you, to you, unto you. These all mean to the people or group or descendants of the same people who Moses is speaking to. For Israel, to Israel, unto Israel. Just like all the other prophets of Yahweh. Let us examine the like jihad for a moment, brother. Any Muslim who claims this argument can easily look up a grocery list of invented characteristics to make Muhammad seem or appear more like Moses than Jesus does. For example, Muhammad had both parents. And that is certainly a logic approach to attempt to redirect the prophecy to fit Muhammad. It is an approach at logic, but it is not logical. Logical arguments are consistent and attempt to derive truth from facts which are proven, establishing more facts in the process. However, Islam is schizophrenic or inconsistent on this approach, and that is a big issue. Have you ever heard that Mohammed is the comforter of John 14, John 15, and John 16? If you are a Muslim, I would wager you have. When Muhammad's followers try to insert Muhammad as the comforter, they will argue the exact opposite point, that Muhammad is like Jesus. Islam will ignore the context but cite John 14:16, which says the following, "And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another comforter, that he may abide with you forever." Islam will argue another means another like Jesus. When Islam attempts to claim Muhammad is another comforter, they will then claim Muhammad is another like Jesus. So in one claim, Deuteronomy 18, they argue Jesus is different than Moses and Muhammad. But when needed, they argue Muhammad is like Jesus, or Jesus is like Muhammad. Fundamental to the proper interpretation of this prophecy in Deuteronomy 18, brother, is to respect the whole text, meaning all the points that describe the prophet. To Israel is the first point, and Muhammad never ever went to Israel as a prophet with a message, even as a simple warner. Islam will attempt to claim the night journey of Surah 17:1 was to Jerusalem. Surah 17:1, "Glory to Allah who did take his servant for a journey by night from the sacred mosque to the farthest mosque, whose precincts we did bless in order that we might show him some of our signs, for he is the one who hears and sees all things." However, that claim has problems. Big problems. First, no one in Israel heard or saw Muhammad. So even if such a magical night trip occurred, no one was warned, and no message from God was delivered. So this offers nothing regarding Muhammad being a prophet to Israel. Second, the word Jerusalem is not even mentioned in the Quran, so no one really knows which mosque Muhammad supposedly visited. No building in Jerusalem was ever called Al-Aqsa before Muhammad. Al-Aqsa was built after Muhammad's death. Jesus was the prophet, just as Jesus claimed, brother. Believe Jesus, believe Moses. Best regards, brother. There is no possible way in heaven or hell that Muhammad possibly fulfills Deuteronomy 18. O Muslim, do you want the truth? May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.